Sims.
Good
yes,
evening. Good evening, sir.
Yeah, the name and the profession.
Yeah, actually, I first like to say I feel like pride like to be an Indian because the university where I grew up, if people talk about Steve Jobs, they do talk about Dr. Jackie Nayak here. My question is, I don't want to criticize any religion because I born in a core priest Hindu family and I'm atheist since 10 years and my background is robotics and software engineer. And the thing is that my question is basically I have two questions and it's only based on today's your today's speech. The first question is, you said the purpose of life is to be an Islamic, is to have an Islamic goal, yeah. I would love to ask you that if we are the creation and we have a creator, so don't you think our creator wants us to be happy? He wants the creation should be happy. So if I love and if I'm happy what I'm doing, but my goal is not Islamic, am I doing wrong? First question is this. And second question is about you say your human body is a very complex machine. And if it's a complex machine, it needs a set of specifications like every machine do need. But see, as a robotic engineer, what I believe, even if you have a machine and if you follow a set of specification, it means you are limiting your thought process. You are limiting, you can't go beyond that. Like if I have a machine, I never read the specifications, I can open the machine, I can put the new RAM, I can put the new processor, I can play around because I never go through the specifications. And at the end, I would love to say that I'm free to accept because I'm very free, I'm very open-minded.
I'll answer both your questions and then come back to you.
Yeah, and just a sec,
and then
sir.
Check your freedom also.
Yeah, okay, no worries, sir. And just a sec, and since at the end, I would love to tell you, right now, I'm in a process of discovering myself because as I told you...
One question at a time, you already asked two questions.
Yeah.
Let me reply to those two questions, okay. Then you can give your comment.
Yeah, okay, no worries, sir.
Your first question, that if I'm the creator and if I made the creation, you want the creation to be happy. So if Almighty God created us and I'm not Islamic and I'm happy in what I'm not Islamic, so the creator should be happy, correct?
No, sir.
No, sir, this is what the question.
I have
summarized your question.
No, I say if I love what I want to do.
That's what I'm trying to tell you. If you love what you want to do and you're happy,
yeah.
So why should the creator be sad?
Yeah.
Correct?
Yeah.
I understood your question.
Yeah.
I'm giving an example. My son, he tells me, Father, I'm happy in taking drugs. I'm saying, but don't take drugs. Father, I'm happy in taking drugs. Why are you interfering with my freedom? What should I do? What should I do?
Okay, but at the end of the day...
Not okay. I am asking you a question.
Yeah.
Will I believe in my son? Arey bhai, you are yet ande mein. Abhi ande ke bahar nikle. Matlab, you're yet young.
Yeah.
You don't know about life.
Okay.
I'm a medical doctor. Correct? No, father, I'm happy. I feel good. I'm in a different world. I take cocaine. I as a father,
okay.
Yeah, even if you feel good, cocaine is bad for you, I will stop. You know, there's one more son is there. I want to jump from the 10-story building. Why? Superman. I will slap him. Why? Superman afterwards. You want to jump? So, a father is cool to be kind. I will not be happy if he's happy. If he's happy doing the right thing, I'll be happy. You understand? Because I'm a father. Our creator is far superior than a father. I may not know everything of life, but the creator knows everything. So the creator knows what is good or what is bad for you. This happiness is temporary. It is temporary. So today you're saying, I am happy not following Islam. It's not the question following Islam. A purpose of life is to worship Allah, worship our creator. Our purpose of life is to obey the guidance of Almighty God. And I said in my lecture, why will God be happy when we follow him? Because it will benefit us. If I tell my son, study, you know, don't have cocaine, have milk, have good food. Why? I'll be happy because it will benefit him. It will not make any benefit to me. So similarly, God, when you follow his commandments, he is happy because it will benefit you. You think you are great. Robotics, coming to your second question, robotics. Yeah.
No, actually, sir, I was confused in the first question here.
What are you confused?
Yeah,
you are saying because you're happy of what you're doing.
No.
Why
no.
should the creator so disagree?
My confusion is that you took it like pessimistically. If you took optimistically, like if I am a robotic engineer.
Robotic comes secondly. First, no. you're talking about Islam.
Yeah, I love making robots. So if I'm really happy, I have a very good sleep at night. At the end of the day, I realize my machines are really working perfectly. I'm really happy. Am I doing wrong? Creating machines.
There is no problem. Does the Quran say don't create a machine?
No, sir.
Listen. You're talking, and you're not listening. The problem is that you're talking and not listening.
No, if you're going
Did
to
I ever say that making robot is haram? I said in my talk, if you follow anything against the commandment of God, it is wrong. Does the Quran say you cannot make machine? No. So what's the problem in making machine? The problem is, if you make machine and start thinking you're God, then there's a problem. You understand, no?
No, sir. Like if
you're... Wait.
Yeah.
You're not listening to the answer and keeping on arguing.
So you asked a question. That's why I'm ready to answer.
No, your question was that if you don't follow Islam and I'm happy in it, why is God not happy? Simple question. Okay. Now you're adding machine to it. Okay. Your machine was to the second question.
But I can see the recording.
Yeah, my memory is very good.
But I say if I love what I'm doing, so I love making
robots. If you love what you're doing and it is not going against the commandment of God, continue doing. But if you love what you're doing which is against the commandment of God, it will cause loss to you and God will not be happy. If my son is doing something, he likes studying and studying is good, I will not be angry. But if he loves having drugs, I will not be happy. Will you be happy your son having drugs?
No, of course not.
Why? Let him be happy. He's making robots after having drugs. Will you be happy?
No, of course not.
So the question is not making robots. Making machine is not haram in Islam. Making machine is not prohibited. That is the second question. Don't merge your first question with your second question.
Your first question was,
what you're doing, you're happy. If it doesn't go against the commandment of God, no problem. But you should also follow the commandment of God. If he says, I make machine, I will not have food, he will die. So there are certain do's and don'ts. If you follow the do's, it will benefit you. If you follow the don'ts, it will cause harm to you. So number one, your purpose of life should be to obey the commandment of God. Number one. Coming to your second question. That if there is a machine, it requires an instruction manual, correct? Now you are talking about robotics. Where did you learn robotics? From the instruction manual only. You are a fool. Without the instruction manual, you learn the instruction manual, now you say you don't want it. Where did you learn about robotics? Did you learn from your mother's womb? Did you learn robotics from your mother's womb?
Basically I learned from my nature. I'm a university dropout.
Forget about dropout. Yeah. Did you read any books on computers or not?
If I say I don't, then?
Then I will say that you're lying.
Then sir, I'm a university dropout. I didn't learn then.
Even Newton, even Albert Einstein was a dropout.
Yeah.
So dropout can be intelligent.
Yeah.
There's no question of being a dropout or not.
Yeah.
Sheikh Didat, you went university dropout. Sheikh Didat, 6 standard pass.
Yeah.
You know, 6 standard pass.
So that doesn't
mean a person if he drops out from a university. You know, Newton, when the apple fell on his head, he was kicked out from the class and the apple fell on his head. Then he thought about the law of Newton. Do you know that? Even you are the dropout. That doesn't mean a dropout cannot become a scientist. My question to you was, irrespective whether you're a dropout or not, did you read books or not?
Sir, but you don't read books for every machine.
I'm asking you a question. For the basics of machine, did you read any book in your life or not?
Yeah, I read high school books.
Those high school books were your instruction manuals.
Yeah.
Correct? So instruction manual is a must for any machine.
But I don't read instruction manual for every single machine. You know, if you read it, then it will restrict your thought for that particular machine.
Okay, if I will give you a machine which you have never seen in your life,
yeah,
will you be able to operate it?
Of course.
Oh, then you got Nobel Prize. I will give you a rocket.
Sir,
you know,
see,
you have asked question.
Sir, you ask
do you know how to fly a rocket?
Sir, you ask.
I'm asking you a question. Do you know how to operate a rocket? Tell the truthful reply. Do you know how to, if I make you sit in a rocket, will you be able to take off?
Sir, you ask me.
I'm asking a question. If I put you in a rocket, will you be able to take off?
Okay, I will operate.
I'm asking
you. I will operate, but it may be successful or not. That's different. You ask me.
It is like using a gun, and the gun you fire and you die yourself. That's suicide.
Sir, see.
Shaikh, please.
Sir, your question was.
I don't. Operate means correctly. Not. It is not suicide. You want to operate a gun and backfires and you die. Yeah, Sheikh.
Yes, but sir,
we don't want such people, please.
Sir, I answer your question, sir. You ask me, can you
that
operate?
That means you're a fool. Can you operate a rocket?
I say I can, but I may fail or I may be successful.
That you're a foolish. That means if you go in a forest, you want to choose the fruit. I will choose whether it's poisonous or not. If I eat a poisonous fruit, I will die.
Sir,
foolish.
Foolish. That's why.
If that means you'll go to a pharmacy. Okay, give me medicine which is black. I will see. Give me medicine which is red. I will eat. I may get cured. I may not get cured. That's foolish.
So that's what my question is.
So we don't want foolish people. We don't. We are not talking about foolish people. This lecture is for people who are logical, not people who are illogical.
Sir, I
will operate,
sir,
but I don't know whether it will.
Illogical, sir. Not illogical. That's my question.
When you go to a pharmacy, when you choose a medicine, and you are sick, will you take any drugs?
Sir, I'm asking, is it a restricting of the thoughts? If I'm choosing fruits, then again, I'm restricting the thoughts.
Yes, your thoughts should be restricted, otherwise it will be danger for somebody else. You want to take off a plane, and there are 500 passengers. All the passengers will die. So who would like to have a pilot like you?
So.
Sorry.
So, sir, now you say, can you operate a machine? Now you're saying that. Risking the other people's life if I don't know how to operate.
You are talking all nonsense. You don't know how to operate a rocket and you want to operate. You want to try. Try and error. In this case, 99.999% you will fail.
So sir,
this
then how
is
you
foolish.
Gonna learn, sir?
Are how you going to learn by reading the instruction manual?
Okay.
So you tell me one thing. You are sick. You go to a pharmacy and say, give me red color medicine. Give me blue color. I will check which drug I will get cured. By the time you get cured, you will die. Please change your lifestyle. Otherwise,
sir,
you will risk your life and somebody else's life also.
Sir,
next question, please.
We have
the next question, please?
We have a non-Muslim lady here.
Yes, sister, most welcome.
Yes.